In this video, we'll look at the range filter for our dashboards. It allows users to apply a filter by selecting a certain interval. A good example of this is choosing certain date timeframes. I already have a dashboard with a grid and a chart that displays some sample data. I'll add the range filter from the ribbon and drag it to the top of the dashboard. Then, drop the sales field to the value section and the current date field to the arguments section. Change the group interval to month-year to display more detailed data within the range filter. Now you can filter dates by dragging beginning and end points. The chart will adjust and display category sales for those specific dates. There's another way you can filter dates. Right-click the range filter and select Custom Period. In the Select Range dialog, choose the dates you want to start and end at and click OK. You can also add predefined ranges for quick selections. Click the Options button next to the argument. Here you can select a range or customize your own and add it to the list. I'll choose Last Year and close the window. Right-click the range and select Last Year from the menu to apply the filter. To learn more about predefined ranges, make sure to check out this video. You can reset filtering using the clear master filter command. Let's look at some more capabilities of the range filter. Drop the category field to series to visualize sales by different categories. You'll see that the range filter will show trend lines similar to the chart below, with the same colors corresponding to categories. Change the series type by clicking the options button next to sales. You can use line, area, and bar series. Just like our other dashboard items, the range filter allows you to change various data-related and interactivity settings. Switch to the Data Ribbon tab and open the filter editor. Here, you can specify criteria to display only the required data. In this video, we'll filter the item by the bikes category. Use Clear to reset the filter criteria. The range filter is designed to work as the master filter item, so it can't be filtered by another item by default. But if you need to, you can change this by disabling the Ignore Master Filters button. Now you can click different states in the grid, and you'll see the data within the range filter is changed. Clear master filtering and switch to the Design tab. Here you can enable and disable a caption. Add text displayed within the caption, or you can select the required series type. The Edit Periods button allows you to manage those predefined ranges I mentioned earlier. Buttons in the Coloring group allow you to manage coloring options of the range filter. Click the Edit Colors button and change the color corresponding to bikes. You can see that both the range filter and chart are colored green. As with most of our dashboard items, you can print and export the range filter to various formats using its context menu. And that's it for this video. To learn more about our dashboards, please make sure to check out the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.